If you've been hearing about ChatGPT, but you're not sure what it actually does, then this video is for you. If you work in content, communications, marketing, or you're just curious about how AI can help you with your everyday life, then keep watching because I'm about to share with you 12 super practical and super useful things you can do with ChatGPT. If you're new here, I'm Aga. I'm an online education business owner with more than 1.5 million followers across my social media platforms. And on this channel, I share my top tips on content, AI, and productivity. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and let's get started. If you've not used ChatGPT before, just go to the ChatGPT website, sign up for free, and you're ready to go. You just write what you need in this box, and I've got a separate video on how to do that well. So when you're ready, check it out and try it yourself. The first thing you can use ChatGPT for is writing anything. Emails is the most obvious one because we all do it, right? ChatGPT can really save you time if you need to write a long email. Just give it the main points that you want to include and hit enter. But what is even more useful is if you need to write something that is quite complex, sensitive, or difficult. In those scenarios, it can really take ages to write an email and to get the tone right. And ChatGPT can really help with that. For example, I'm going to ask ChatGPT to write me an email to my boss who has invited me to her 40th birthday party, which is very important to her. But I want to explain in the email that I won't be able to make it. So I want to provide a good excuse and make the email sound like I really care and I'm sorry I won't be there. So this is quite a difficult message and I want to get it right. Let's see how ChatGPT can help me with that. So we've got a first version of this. So the email starts with, "I hope you're having a wonderful week and everything is coming together beautifully for your big celebration." And then it does provide an excuse, which is about a family commitment. So it is following my instructions. This is essentially a basic email based on basic instructions. If you don't like it, you can always edit it yourself or you can ask ChatGPT to refine it based on further instructions that you give it. I've also got a video about how to get started with writing with ChatGPT and other AI tools, so make sure you check that out as well. You can also use ChatGPT to brainstorm ideas. If you're ever stuck staring at a blank page, just tell ChatGPT what you're trying to come up with, who your target audience is, what you're trying to achieve, and it will give you lots of content ideas. You can then refine them further, and I've got a separate video about how to brainstorm effectively with AI, so make sure you check that out as well. The next one is editing and proofreading. If you've written something, but you're not sure it sounds right, or if you're not sure if the grammar is correct, just paste it in, and ChatGPT can check the grammar, suggest edits, or help you make it more concise or more persuasive. So I'm going to use an article that I wrote a few years ago, which is about what is the easiest language to learn. And I'm going to ask ChatGPT to check the grammar and offer improvements to the style of this article. Then I'm going to paste the article in and see what it comes up with. So as you can see, it's given me an alternative version of that section. So there's three different types of improvements it's suggested: clarity and flow, tone and engagement, and grammar. So it explains step by step how you can make a piece of writing better. Summarizing long stuff. ChatGPT can really help you with a research of any kind by summarizing things like long articles or reports. Paste it into ChatGPT and ask for a summary. You can even ask it to summarize things in a specific format, like bullet points. So imagine you're trying to do some research into whether or not you should be using protein powder. So I found this article, which is quite long, and I just want to understand the gist of it. So I'm going to paste it into ChatGPT, and I'm going to ask it for a summary. So give me a summary of this article. And I'm also going to ask it to use bullet points so that I can scan the summary really easily. So this is the summary it's given me. It started with the risks of using protein powder And then some advantages, some alternatives, and some recommendations about daily intake. So I can scan this really easily just by looking at the bullet points and then decide if I want to read this article in detail or not. Obviously, it's very important to think critically about the content that you're getting from ChatGPT, but it saved me a bit of time in terms of reading everything from the report. The next one is explaining complicated topics. If you're not sure how something works, like blockchain, getting a mortgage, or applying to university, ask ChatGPT to explain it to you like you're 5 years old or like you're new to the topic. It will break it down for you into easy to understand chunks. The next one, which I absolutely love, is that you can use ChatGPT to learn new skills. Say you want to learn how to be a better writer, how to use a specific parenting technique, or how to grow vegetables in your back garden. ChatGPT can act as a tutor or a coach, explaining things step by step, at your own pace, suggesting learning paths and strategies that you can try out. The next one is preparing presentations. If you need to give a talk or a presentation, ChatGPT can really help you with things like outlining the key points that you want to communicate, suggesting content or images for your slides, or even things like writing your script. The next one is practicing conversations. So this could be, for example, a job interview that you're preparing for, or a difficult conversation you need to have with a family member or a colleague. ChatGPT can help you phrase things in a specific way to help you achieve what you're trying to achieve with the conversation. You can also give it things that you would say in a particular situation, and it can give you feedback on those things. The next one is super useful. It's about planning trips. ChatGPT can be really helpful when planning a trip or a holiday. It can help you design an itinerary, suggest things to do, give you some insights or stories about the places you'll be visiting, and even recommend what and where to eat. The next one is related. It's about translating. Sometimes you may need to translate something into another language or back into your own language, and ChatGPT can do that for you. It can also help you understand or adapt your own messages to the local culture or audience. And the next one, creating images. If you want to create an image with ChatGPT, you just need to give it instructions about what kind of image you're looking for. I'm going to ask it for an oil painting of a mountain scene in winter. And let's see what it comes up with. So it is generating the image. So this is just a basic instruction, but my detailed video tells you all about how to get your images right. And here's the product. And finally, ChatGPT can help you with all the fun things in your life, like meal planning, recipes, workout ideas, book and film recommendations. So imagine you're trying to come up with something to eat, but you only have a limited number of ingredients in your fridge. So we want to ask ChatGPT to come up with some recipe suggestions using those ingredients. So I said, I only have carrots, sweet corn, rice, coriander, and some spices at home, and I wanted to suggest 3 recipes using these ingredients. So let's see what it comes up with. Spiced carrot and sweet corn fried rice. So it's given you the instructions for that. Carrot and corn spiced patties. Yeah, why not? Warm carrot, corn and rice salad. So instantly you've got some ideas for what you can do with those ingredients. So if you want to try any of these things out, like I said, just go to the ChatGPT website, sign up for free, and the free version is perfectly fine if you want to experiment and see what ChatGPT can do for you. If this video helped you, make sure you give it a like and tell me in the comments, what are you using ChatGPT for? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.